last class we discussed, I have given introduction about economic growth, economic development, objectives of economic development, and also I explained what are indicators of economic development. Just I will brief in short what are the indicators. First indicator is national income. Second indicator is per capita income. Third indicator is real national income. These three are income indicators. The next one is physical quality of life as index. This says about improvement of physical quality of life such as health and education. Next one is I said about human development indicator. It is modal indicator. So what are the factors which impact human development is life expectancy, income for better living and education. Then I explained gender equality index. Then next one is social progress index and multi poverty dimensional index. Today's class I will start with factors hindering economic development. What are the factors which are obstacles for economic development, or factors which comes in the way of economic development? First one is lack of natural resources. You know students, what are natural resources? First one is land, second one is water, rivers, minerals, oils, forest, all comes under natural resources. Developed countries have plenty of resources. They know, even though some countries like Singapore like that have less resources, but they use technology and they are making best use of resources. But mostly developed country have natural resources. Some countries like poor countries like Africa like that have plenty of resources, but they don't know how to utilize the resources, how to use technology. They don't know good cultivation techniques to produce more output. So lack of resources, inadequate natural resources for developing countries, mostly based on agriculture. They don't know how to use proper ways of cultivation. Then the main hindrance is that developing countries like India are more populous. Because they have more population, there will be decrease in fertility of soil. Fertility of soil, why fertility of soil is very, very important to get more output from agricultural produce. Because developing countries could not properly use this, make use of these natural resources because of lack of technology and because of lack of research and development and lack of competition in agriculture sector. So in this inadequate natural resources, they are divided into two types. First one is untapped resources. What are untapped resources? As I said, some sub-African regions are what? Very rich in resources, very rich in natural resources. But they can't make proper utilize of these resources because of lack of technology and they don't know to use the modern methods of cultivation. That is the main thing that is called untapped resources. Best example is Singapore students, where natural resources are very, very less in Singapore and Japan. But using technology, they have produced more output, they developed their natural resources. Second one is inefficiently managed resources. What is inefficiently managed resources means? There is no proper planning. No proper planning in managing these resources, like because of closed economic policy. So they have no, when there is no proper planning, they don't know how to manage, how to make best use of resources. That is called inefficient managed resources. So first hindrance is what? The lack of natural resources or inadequate natural resources. In that, first one is untapped resources. The second one is inefficiently managed resources. Second one is lower rate of growth of capital. What is lower rate of growth of capital? Human capital. What is human capital? As I said, girls, human capital means efficient, depends on labor, efficiency of labor. Labor as a capital investment. So in developing countries, allocation of budget will be very less on health and education. Why? There are three factors why there is less allocation of budget on health and education. First factor is falling of export revenue of agriculture produce. So what is this falling of export revenue of agriculture? Because much restrictions are laid by developed countries on import of the underdeveloped countries. What is this, girls? Falling of export revenue of agriculture produce. Why there will be fall in revenue of exports of agriculture produce? Because developed countries are imposing very strict measures on imports of our countries. Much restrictions on exports make lower rate of exports. Second one is lack of. So the second one is for girls, most of our revenue, most of our national income is devoted to pay debts for International Monetary Funds and World Bank. Because of less export revenue, what happens? Most of our income we are devoting to pay, to clear the debts. What is this? This to whom? International Monetary Fund. We call it as IMF. That is called International Monetary Fund and World Bank. Next one is strict financial institutions are imposing strict restrictions by repaying loans. So there are financial institutions and banks are imposing very, very strict restrictions while repaying loans. That makes our rate of human capital fall off human capital. This is mainly because in India, developing countries and underdeveloping countries, so many people don't know how to read, how to write, how to make arithmetic equations, and don't know how to use technology. That is, the education plays very, very important role in development of what? Human capital. In India, there is lack of education facilities, and second one is lack of health facilities. There is poverty mainly because so many people in India are uneducated, not giving more importance for education because of closed economic policy, lack of infrastructure. What is this infrastructure? First, improvement in what? Telecommunications, okay, transport systems, by constructing good roads, bridges, so we can easily make imports and exports of goods. But in developing country, because of lack of infrastructure, these imports, because of bad conditions of roads and bad poor bridges construction, we could not have this foreign trade. Why this infrastructure is very low? As I said, most of our national income is diverted toward repaying debts. So we could not give much importance for development of infrastructure. Fourth hindrances of economic development is vicious circle of poverty. This is very important, girls. Very important factors which come in the way of economic development. As I said, developed countries have good education facilities, health facilities, capital investment is high, savings are high, they are very well developed. But underdeveloped countries and developing countries like India, this is bottleneck which comes in the way of development. They are poor. They could not, once they enter into this circle, once they become poor, they could not come out of this poverty, vicious circle of poverty. Means what? Once they enter, they could not come out. Why means? I will explain this with following diagram. Developing economies with special reference. reference to India. Till now we have seen what are the factors of influencing economic development hindrances. So based on per capita income, based on development, world economies are mainly divided into three types. What is based on GNI per capita income? What is this GNI per capita income? Means whole country's income will be converted into dollars and they will measure economic development. They will see what are the conditions which makes a country, developed country, which is entirely different with developing countries and underdeveloped countries. That is based on GNI per capita income, whole Indian economy, so whole world economy, sorry, the whole world economy is divided into three types. First one is lower income economies. What are lower income economies? The underdeveloped countries. So when nation per capita income is dollars 1035 or less, it is said to be lower income economy. What is lower income economy? When per capita income is dollars 1035 or less. Underdeveloped countries like Congo have only $7.75, which are very very underdeveloped countries. Second one, see this second, developing economies are divided based on dollars. They are divided based on per capita income. They are divided into two types. Second one is divided into two types. First one is lower middle income economies. So what is lower middle income economies? Lower middle income economies. If per capita income is dollars 1036 or equal to $4,085. We will say it as lower middle income economies. Next one is upper middle income economies. If per capita income is dollars 4086, ranging from 4086 to $12,615, we can say it as upper middle income economies. That is, this comes under category of developing countries. Next one is higher income economies. If per capita income is dollars 12,660 or more than this, we can say it as higher income economies. So what is this? How we divide world economy into developed and developing? Based on GNI per capita income. This is based on 2014 statistics. This every year, every July 1st, they will calculate this world, they will divide world economies. Sometimes based on dollars, increase in dollar per capita income, they may change. Developing countries' nature may be changed. But World Bank report 2014 has mainly divided world economies into basically three types. That is based on GNI per capita income. What is GNI per capita income? Whole income of a country or total income of a country is expressed in terms of dollars to measure whether a country is developing, underdeveloped or developed economies. Okay, guys. Then we will see next topic, characteristics of developed countries. So what is this developed countries economies? income ranging from $1,260 or more. If per capita income is $12,660 or more, we will classify it as developed economies. We will see. Till now I have said about development, growth and all. So what is development? Increase. Mainly when I am explaining economic development, I said structural changes in industrial production. Structural changes in national output. That is dependence on industrial sector and territory sector rather than primary sector, that is agriculture. As developed countries have high rate of investment, they have high rate of investment which leads to high rate of savings, and they are less populated, so they enjoy the fruits of economic development. They consume more nutritious food, they are developed education wise, they are developed using of technology, they are developed. Like the developed states have enjoyed full fruits of development. First characteristics of developed economy is significance of industrial sector. See girls, in India, 2/3 of population depends on agriculture, contributing 80% of national income. What girls, in India, I am telling about developing country like India, 2/3 of world population depends on agriculture, contributing only 18% of national income. But whereas developed countries, mainly they depend on industries, whether it is small scale, large scale, they depend most of the income they will get from or industrial sector. But see girls, in UK actually share of capital in industrial sector is first 25% from industrial sector. 25% of national income in UK they will get from industrial sector. Then 4% of national income is derived from agricultural sector. 21% of income from transport and communication. So this shows importance of industrial and service sector in contributing to the economic development. So what is significance of industrial sector? They have high efficiency of labor, human capital, because of high education. They have good education skills. They can contribute. The share of national income will be contributed mainly from industrial sector rather than territory sector, rather than agriculture sector. Second one is high rate of capital formation. Second thing is high rate of capital formation. What is capital formation? Investment in business. It will be more in developed countries. As quality, they use quality of resources, they will produce more goods and services through industrial sector. So capital formation will be high, thereby increasing rate of savings. Savings will be high. So when savings will be high, they will demand more quality of, they can produce and demand quality of goods and services. So in UK, 25% of contribution of national income towards capital formation in developed countries. 20-25% of capital formation will be taken developed from of. So 25% of national income their formation. So that is because of using high technology, sophisticated machinery, using more research and development, they will produce, and quality of labor will be more, they will produce more quantity of goods and services. Next one is use of modern techniques and skills. This system says that developed country is towards the era of modernization. They use in agriculture, in each and every field, they use mostly modern techniques. They have research and development. They have research and development even in agriculture to increase the capacity, increase the cultivation. They use modern techniques. Okay, girls, that is sophisticated technology and human skills, labor skills will be more in developed country rather than developing countries like economy. Next one is low growth rate of population. This is very, very important characteristics of developed economies, that is low rate of population. Increase in population will be very, very less compared to developed countries. So, compared to developing economies, population will be very, very less. Because population will be less, there will be more education. Then when there is more education, there will be more income. Again, when there is more income, rate of savings will be more. When there is rate of savings, again they will invest in development of economy. With less population, they can enjoy fruits of development. All the people in the country, in developed countries, enjoy the fruits of development in developed economies. Next one is per capita GNI income, that is standard of living, or per capita GNI will be more in developed countries rather than developing countries. These are the main differences between developed, these are the main characteristics of developed country. What is first one? Significance of industrial sector, high rate of capital formation, use of modern techniques. See, this girl's use of modern techniques. Japan and Singapore are very, very small countries, but because of using more technology, using research and development, they become developed economies only through using modern techniques and skills. And research and development in India, it will be only amount invested for research and development is 0.81%. But in developed countries like USA, it is 2.79%. This shows investment on research and development will be more in developed countries rather than developing countries. Low growth of population and per capita GNI. Per capita GNI is very, very, it will be very high in developed countries compared to developing economies. Now we will discuss very, very important topic, girls, characteristics of developing economies with special reference to India. It is very, very important question from examination point of view also. So listen carefully. What are characteristics of developing economies with special reference to India? We have seen characteristics of developed economies. Now we'll see characteristics of developing economies. So developing economies, underdeveloped economies, as I said, there are many factors which come in the way of hindrance or which come in the way of economic development. There are natural resources, most predominance of agriculture, then no capital formation, everything makes this developed countries different from developing economies. First characteristics of developing economy is low level of income. So what is low level of income? As I said, low level of contribution towards national income is very very less compared to developed countries. In India, contribution towards national income is very less. Out of 133 countries in the world, India stands 110th position. 110th position in contribution towards national income. So what does, if we say, if we compare 133 countries in contribution towards national income, India stands 110th position. That is, 109 countries have more income than India. Why? Mainly because of poverty. Low level of income leads to low level of savings. Again, low level of savings, and because of low level of savings, they could not consume proper food, nutritious food. This poverty is mainly because low level of income, and poverty is because mainly of increasing population. India is too populous country. So what happens? If savings will be very very less. For example, if we take, as I said, mostly 1/3 of people in India are below poverty line, could not consume proper food. They don't have basic needs like food, clothing and shelter. Because of that, what happens? Their capacity, their level, health level, life expectancy will be less. Because of improper health condition, they could not work. There will be more absence of work, which leads to low production and which leads to low savings. That is called low level of income towards India. Level of income is national contribution towards national income is very less because of poverty. Second one is predominance of agriculture. In India, thus 2/3 of India's population depends on agriculture, contributing 18% to the national income. This shows, means what? Agriculture is main source of income. Agriculture dominates. Main source of income we get is from agriculture. So 2/3 of world, India's population depends on agriculture, contributing only 18%. Whereas developed countries, 2 to 4% depends on agriculture, contributing 2 to 6% towards national income. Why we are getting less income? Because rainfall is the main source of irrigation in India. We depend on rains for agricultural output. We don't have proper irrigation facilities. Now Telangana government say they started Mission Kakatiya and everything to improve irrigation facilities. But previously mainly we used to depend on rainfall. Some of the sectors, some of the peat farmers are using modern techniques of cultivation. But mostly Indians, they are not in India. In agriculture, they are not using modern. They are using only old methods of technology, which reduces cultivation. Cultivation techniques are not sophisticated. Third one is capital deficiency. What is capital deficiency? In developed countries, we have seen high rate of capital formation. Here we see capital deficiency. Low, high level of, there is most capital deficiency, which leads to low level of rate of investment will be less, rate of savings will be less. Most of, we could not use most of the labor and the natural resources in India because of lack of capital. That is, capital is not utilized properly because of lack of capital, labor skills and natural resources are not properly utilized in India, which leads again to low capital formation. Low capital formation leads to low savings. Low savings, we don't have technology, we could not use natural resources and human labor, because labor also, they are not skilled, unskilled labor, which reduces capital investment. Next one is technological backwardness. Developed countries, as I said, are modernized. They use high sophisticated technology. But in India, technology, what we are using in industries is also very, very low compared to developed countries. Even though some industries, some sectors are using this technology, sophisticated technology, most of the industries are not still used for this improvement of technology. They are using only outdated methods of technology. That is called technological backwardness. In developed countries, even though resources are less, even though everything, natural resources are less and all, by using technology, they are producing more goods. But even in our country like India, even though we have natural resources, we cannot use properly because of lack of technology. Next one is inadequate infrastructural facilities. What comes in infrastructural facilities? I said telecommunications, transport comes in under infrastructural facilities. Most of the Indian economy is not using proper infrastructural facilities because lack of capital. They could not properly use these infrastructural facilities. That's why foreign investment, they could not, because of lack of infrastructural facilities, they could not attract foreign investment. Next one is high growth rate of population. This is the main concept why India is still in the stage of development. What is this? High growth rate of population. Increase in population is very, very high. According to 2011 census, it is what population is 121 crores. We have 121 according to 2011 census. The population rises is 121 crores. That is 1.84% of increase in population. That is high rate of population. Because when there is more population, what happens to us? Everything land. So everything becomes very congested. So many people are not having basic needs like food, clothing and shelter because of high growth rate of population. Poverty dominates. So they depend mostly on agriculture. When the agriculture, mostly 70% of our people lives in villages, depend on agriculture. They will not consider having more children as burden. So what happens? Population is rising continuously because of high growth of population, the rate of savings, capital deficiency, use of natural resources like land will be more. So that is the main disadvantage of developing countries. There is poverty in India because of high growth of population. Most of the people, because of high growth rate of population, most of the people are uneducated, not having proper health facilities, basic amenities, and they could not contribute towards economic development. They don't want to change themselves. They feel they are poor because that they will accept that poverty. That is called high growth rate of population. Next one is high rate of illiteracy. What is illiteracy? Not having proper education. So most of now this literacy rate is slowly improving, but most of the Indians are still not having proper education. So compared to male are more educated. So there is more education in male is more in India compared to female education. Next one is high infant mortality rate. Or as I said, what is infant means? Infant means children below 1 year of age. So in India we have high infant mortality rate. Infant mortality rate, people, children dying before age of 1 year is more because of lack of nutritious food, lack of sanitation conditions, lack of health facilities makes infant mortality rate high in India compared to developed countries. Next one is tradition from attitudes towards work. So what does in India? We usually do not accept change. It takes so many years for us to accept change. We will not adopt modern techniques in agriculture. We are working because of we are India is dominated by social customs, traditions, which will not make people accept modernization. They follow only old methods, old techniques. Even in agriculture, they will not follow modern technology because of in India we are dominated by more customs. See, family planning also. So many people are not in favor of family planning because of their customs and tradition. Especially people in villages do not want to accept family planning. As I said, they consider having more children. They do not consider having more children as burden. But if they have more children, they can send it to the farms and they can get more income. They feel like that. That is the main thing in developing economies, that is tradition bound attitudes towards work. They are not acceptable to change. So next one is joint family system. Till recently we have more joint family system. Now we are adopting nuclear families. Previously we had joint family system. So joint family, why this is not advantageous? Only joint family, so many people live together. They don't want to go to another place for work. As they only one member will work and all other members will depend on head of the family for income. So because of joint family system, which leads to poverty, they are not ready to shift from one place to another place. That these are the main disadvantages or characteristics of developing economy with special preference to India. Even though girls now slowly, our Indian economy is developing, but most, even though we want to accept change because of more population, heavy pressure on land, some industries not adopting change, still we are in the law of development. Not fully all the people are not enjoying the fruits of economic development because of these factors. Just again I will say, what are they? Low level of income, predominance of agriculture, capital deficiency, technological backwardness, inadequate infrastructural facilities, high growth rate of population, high rate of illiteracy, high infant mortality rate, traditions bound attitudes towards work, joint family system. With this, I end today's topic. Thank you.